Hi guys, in today's video I'll show you the new safety features of the original Prusa i3 Mark III. But before we start any test, check in the settings that both crash detection and filament sensor are turned on. First, I'll show you the filament sensor. To test the filament sensor, get a pair of side cutters. Now, just simply cut the filament at the extruder opening and try to have the cut as perpendicular as possible. Now we just wait until the filament sensor detects it. If you cut the filament at an angle or a steep angle, it might not detect. Okay, so now the printer detected that the filament has run out. Now the printer asks you to unload the filament. So just confirm with the knob and prepare to remove it as soon as possible. When you are ready and auto-loading is enabled, just insert the filament into the extruder and extruder will pull it in automatically. And if the auto-loading is disabled, you have to confirm the loading with the button. Now prepare to remove some of the extruded filament and press yes. And the printer continues. Now let's test the power panic. Do not use the power button because that's for turning the printer off. Do not test it by unplugging and plugging back the power cord because it may introduce arcing and trigger the power panic multiple times, which may render it not working properly. Closest to the real world scenario is to have an extension cord with a switch and just switch it off. When we switch it back on, the power panic kicks in and tries to rehome the printer and get back to the printing temperatures before it continues. If the printer was powered off for a long time and the temperatures cool down too much, before it tries to recover the print, it asks you to check if the print is still secure to the bed. Because in case of some materials, they might get loose when the heat bed cools down. And we successfully recovered. Next test is the crash detection. Always just pinch the rods and wait for the extruder to crash into your fingers. As we can see, it successfully detected crash and it rehomes and continues. Testing the crash detection by pushing into the extruder will not work in case you actually push it in the direction the extruder is already moving. It will not detect the crash. Also, if you are printing something very small, the crash detection thresholds are set for higher speeds and it will probably not trigger. But that is fine because in real world scenarios, the layer shifting or the crashes happen when the extruder is moving fast between large objects and when something, for example, curls up and the nozzle crashes into that. And remember, the crash detection doesn't work in stealth mode, only in the normal mode. So, our print finished. Even though we tried to abuse the printer, it finished perfectly, as you might see. And I wish you happy printing.